Haddon. This is RTE One.
It's been a lovely evening.
Maybe I could walk you home?
No, but you could walk me back to your place.
Whoa. You guys know each other?
Of course we do. This is my little sister.
Tanya Jeffries.
I've written a report advising that Shorten Street remains open.
All you have to do is sign it and send it to the ministry, and nobody will ever find out that you've been accepting kickbacks. Someone driving my car hit and injured a woman and then drove off. Was it you?
I'm sorry.
It was me. You're a lying little cow, you know that. You drove Andrew's car to a dance party and you were in it when Gemma was hit. Because the Jake I know wouldn't have done that.
Look, I'm 3 months younger than you. I won't be looking at a jail term, but you could. Please don't do that because you feel you owe me something.
I'm not. Are you alive?
I can't feel my body. I think I'm paralyzed.
It's time to get up then.
Well, no, wait. I think it's passing. It's a miracle.
Don't. Robin's gonna be here any minute. Stop it. Robin will be here soon.
Well, you just have to tell her to go away then, won't you?
I can't be that rude.
Without even trying.
Andrew will be here soon.
Andrew who? Not letting you go.
I liked you better paralyzed.
You lie.
I so wish I'd been there, but then I'd have behaved disgracefully. Laughed in her face, hooted and hollered. Oh.
To Shorten Street.
Forever. And no more Medi.
I hope we're not celebrating too soon. The ministry are going to wonder why she changed her mind.
Don't go all cautious on me now.
But what is definitely worth celebrating is the look on Meta's face when she knew I had her.
Do it again.
Mind you, I was sweating. I had no proof at all that she was in bed with a construction company.
You demon. I had no idea you could play so dirty. I think I'm a little shocked.
Really?
Maybe it's not shock. Maybe it's, Definitely.
Working late.
Reading up on radiotherapy treatment. I want to make sure Norman's fully informed.
Have you considered a PowerPoint presentation?
Is that a joke?
Clearly not.
I'm not going to apologise for trying to save his life.
I don't expect you to. I'd probably do the same thing.
Would you?
Yes. I admire your determination.
But?
No buts. One but.
What?
Don't forget to look after yourself. Otherwise, you won't be much use to anyone.
The head of nursing was lovely, but the minute she mentioned babies, I went on and on like a nutcase. Honestly, there's no way she'll hire me.
Being child-friendly isn't going to count against you, babe.
No, there is a difference between being child-friendly and child-obsessed. Honestly, once I opened my mouth, I couldn't shut it.
Could you shut it now?
I beg your pardon?
Don't worry, I'm leaving. Was rude, even for Lee May.
She's going through a stressful time at the moment.
Yeah.
Do you promise me?
Yeah.
That you will never, ever get sick?
Of course.
So.
Hey, Stud.
Okay, now you know I was only kidding about the sperm donor thing, eh?
No.
Well, it'll be all wrong for me right now. Life's got a bit messy and I kind of like to straighten up. Fly right. No way am I ready to be a dad.
So serious, mate?
Yeah, Vinnie Crusade, serious. Real funny.
Okay, where's the punchline?
Hey, Vinnie.
Look, I'm all right, okay? See you guys later.
My beautiful brown hip babies for us.
Yeah, plenty of beautiful brown hip daddies out there.
Well, we'd best be looking for them then, eh? Let's get the show on the road.
Yeah.
Go.
I'm going.
Jake.
Oh, I'm late.
That's okay.
I couldn't make up my mind, so I got both.
Cool. Do you want a coffee or something?
How about ice cream?
Yum.
So, do you want heartwarming or...
Well, what?
Not exactly Andrew's style. Jake. Hi. Well, by the looks of things, this isn't the only thing to have come off.
Gosh,
you're kind of here when you shouldn't be here, doing what you kind of shouldn't be doing. Hi.
Brian. Hi, Claire.
Hi. Do you want some ice cream?
Not at the moment, thank you.
Claire felt like some company.
Yeah, I thought you'd be late like usual.
We were just going to watch a DVD, but if you're here...
Don't let me stop you, and you certainly don't have to go home. It was good of you to come over. Thank you.
Wow, sitting up and writing. The miracle of modern medicine. What is it? Oh, come on, let me see.
I don't know.
Why?
Well, it's a work in progress.
Oh, come on, what is it? Caterers? Music? Sounds like a party.
Yeah. My funeral. I'm just being practical.
Practical would be not giving up.
Hey, I'm not giving up.
Then you don't need this.
Yes, I do.
I'm working my butt off trying to keep you alive, and you're already planning your own funeral?
Will you just stop for a second and let me explain? See... My parents died without a will. And what did they get? Dial a funeral. Before I even realized what was happening, that was it. It was over. Everyone was gone. It was like Mum and Dad were never even there. They deserved better. And I'm not going out that way.
Stop it, Norman. You're not going to die.
Everyone has to die. I just want to get the stuff done now so I don't have to worry about it.
You need to focus on getting better.
Well, I feel better already. Babe, I'm the last of the Hansons. That's it, no more. We deserve a good send-off, and I'm trying to plan the party for a decade here, so why don't you stop the grumping and just start helping me?
This is really good of you, mate.
Oh, just no problem.
As I said on the phone, I just don't believe that Jake did it. I know, coming from his father, that probably sounds pretty biased.
Well, that doesn't mean you're wrong, though.
Yeah, but how do we get the truth out of him?
Morning.
Hugo, Jake, this is Hugo, the lawyer I told you about.
Your dad's asked me to help you prepare for the meeting with Youth Aid tomorrow.
And for the conference with Gemma's parents.
I don't need a lawyer. I know what the meetings are about. The cops told me.
Jake, just hear him out.
Okay, so you realise that Gemma and her family can order you to take action to ensure you don't offend again?
Like a defensive driving course.
Yeah, or possibly a pretty hefty community sentence.
Yeah.
But the real reason for these meetings is so that Gemma can talk about the accident, how it's affected her.
So I'll just listen.
And she's going to have a lot to ask you, so will her parents. Now, there's every chance they might have a real go at you. You're just going to have to sit there and wear it. How you react is crucial. Don't get defensive.
Or lippy.
It might be pretty grueling, but if you have some idea of what to expect, it might make it easier for you. So why don't I ask you a couple of questions, eh? Whose idea was it to go to the shops that morning? Yours or Claire's?